Hello and welcome back. Here is an interesting question by one of my video subscribers, and he says, I'm working on an inventory project where I have a text box for ID. ID is of the format ST-AUG for August-0001. I wish to increment the month from AUG to September and so on after each month, and also increment sequence 0001 to 002 every time. I click on the transfer button in user form. Please explain with a video. Thank you in advance. So basically, this is about how to make super fast data entries automatically. I'm going to minimize this now, and I have created the macro here, which I will explain to you step by step. But before that, let me show you it in action. So we will run this by clicking on the run button, and you see a user form pops up. And if I write here, for example, ST-Jan-0001, and I transfer the data, so the data will go from my user form to the next blank row in the Excel worksheet. I'm transferring only the item ID. Of course, in real world, you will have number of text boxes, maybe even combo boxes, list boxes, and so on. But at the moment, we want to concentrate only on this item ID. So let's click on transfer. So when I click on transfer, see what happens. First of all, it checks whether this is a valid entry, and it gives me a message. Okay, so we'll click on OK, and the data is transferred to the Excel worksheet. And please note here, the next entry is ready. If you click on transfer again, valid ID entry, okay, data is transferred, and you see it becomes March and 003. Now let's have a look at the VBA code. I tried to make this code as general as possible, and of course you can improve it according to your needs. So we'll close the user form by clicking on the close button, and we are brought back to our Visual Basic editor. This is our user form. I'm assuming that you know how to enter a text box and a command button in a user form. So we will double click on the transfer button, which has all the code. The close code is just unload me. So let me show you that. So double click, and there you see it has just two words and one line of code, and it says unload me. Okay. We'll view the object again, and we'll double click on the transfer command button, and here is the code for the command button called transfer. So I declare a variable called dim my num as long. My num will give me the number that you see after the zeros. The E row, or the next blank row, is first calculated by calculating or assigning the last row, and obviously the E row will be last row plus 1. And the assignment of the last row is pretty simple, easy, straightforward, and there are a number of videos I've made on this. So what do we do first? How do we validate the user's data entry in the first instance? So when he types in the data, we say if textbox1.text is like, actually just like, and you see we have two, so he can enter only two capital letters. Then he can enter a dash, then he enters three capital letters for the month, and finally he can enter a dash and four numerical characters. For example, 0001. I have expanded this a little bit. When the number goes beyond 10, So I've added one more, and if it goes beyond 100, then the validation takes place like this. Okay, so in the first instance, what do? As soon as the data comes and we click on the button, it will go to the range A and E row, that is the next blank row, only and only if the data has been validated. That means the entry is 2 capital letters dash 3 capital letters for the month, that means AUG for August, dash and the 4 numerical or 5 or 6 numerical characters, then the data will be transferred, else you will get a message invalid ID entry, and it will exit the sub and you'll have to make the entry again. Now what do? Because the possibilities of entering data are slightly different depending on the numerical characters, we need to first calculate the length of the text box. So if the length is 11, that means st-aug-0001, then we take the first character and my num will become my number or my num plus 1. That's what you saw. When I click on the transfer button, data is transferred and the my num becomes from 0001 to 0002, right? In case the person has 12 characters, because it is going beyond 10, then we extract 2 characters, and if it is beyond 100, then we extract 3 characters to get the right number in our ID. Now what do? How do we get the data, the month? We extract the month by using the mid text function, and then we add 1 and a year date to convert this into a complete date. Okay, and from that we get the month value. That means if it is AUG, that is August, then we will get the value 8 into our text box, and we will add 1 to it to make it September, so it will become 9. Okay, and because text box only contain text, we convert that into a number by using the val function. So then we say if the text box 1 is greater than 12, that means we have reached December, then we set it back, we set the text box value back to this date. For example, 1st Jan and the present year plus 1. So if it is 2019, it will become 2020, and we again extract the number. Yeah, the number of that month. So in this case, for example, it will be 1, and the system will keep on running. Here we will get the month number, and then what we will do, we will say the text box 1 value will become ST, because that's what the user wants. So if you have some other value, you can put it here. Please remember, if you put more than 2, then you will have to change the code accordingly. Then what do? We extract the month name using the month number. Okay, so in our text box, we use the month number, and we convert it into the month name, and we say we only want the first 3 characters of the month name. For example, for September we want only SEP, for January we only want JAN. Okay, then we concatenate that with a dash, we concatenate that with 000, 3 zeros and my number, which is the number at the end of the zeros, as I showed. Okay, so pretty straightforward. So you have here a validation of the data entering the text box, and you have the automation of converting the complete ID as the user keeps on transferring data. Now this becomes a super fast method to make proper data entries into your worksheet to do whatever you like to do in Excel. So let's go back to our run button. Let's click on this run button, and you see here, if I write something now. For example, if I write st-mar-00, let's say 3. I'm just doing it properly so that you see how this will be transferred. First, data validation takes place, entry is done, and the next entry is ready. If you don't want to do that, fine. So we can close this. Okay. And if you don't want to go to the Visual Basic Editor every time you're working in the program, you can go here, you can create a button, and you can attach that to a module. So let's see how we can do that. So we'll go to the Developer tab, Visual Basic, we'll say Insert Module, and we'll insert, for example, sub show user form. Okay, and we'll write user form 1.show. So this is our module that we write. We can save this. We go back to our Excel worksheet. From the Developer tab, we go to Insert. We select the form control button, click and drag. You can press the Alt key so that the alignment of the button is perfect. And a new window called Assign Macro pops up, so you can assign it to show user form that we just created. And we'll say OK. And we can edit this button by clicking here, deleting the button 1, and we'll say show user form. We'll click outside so that the selection goes away, and now you see you have a hand. If you click here, your user form will fire up and you can start working. So you close it, and you want it again, you get it here. I hope you found this interesting and useful. If you did, please tell your friends on social media, and if you haven't subscribed as yet, please do so. Thanks for watching.